The US Navy's been running tests of the MQ-25 Stingray on USS George H.W. Bush as it operates in the Atlantic. Naval Air Systems Command said that the tests on the Bush focused on the MQ-25's deck handling system during the day and nighttime operations. Those included taxiing and parking on the flight deck, connecting to the catapult, and clearing the landing area. MQ-25 deck operators used Boeing's new deck control device. Basically, packs the operators carry on their backs and arms to operate the drone. The deck handling demonstration on the USS George H.W. Bush followed a two-year flight test campaign for the Boeing-owned T1 test aircraft. In this period, Boeing and the U.S. Navy refueled F/A-18 Super Hornet, E-2D Hawkeye, and F-35C Lightning II carrier-based aircraft. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes why the MQ-25 refueling drone would make U.S. supercarriers much more deadly. Let's get started. This video is sponsored by War Thunder. If you are, like us, fascinated by military vehicles and technology, I recommend you give War Thunder a try. It's a military vehicle combat game which you can download and play for free on PC, PlayStation 4, and Xbox One with cross-platform support. It has a huge variety of more than 1,200 playable aircraft, tanks, helicopters, and ships from the 1930s to the 1990s, which you can take to battle on land, in the air, and at sea on more than 80 theaters of war. War Thunder's been kind enough to offer all Defense Updates viewers a special bonus, which will grant you a free premium tank, aircraft, or ship, and 3 days of premium account time for registering using our link in the description below. So take the plunge and join more than 20 million players from around the world. As part of the testing, the Navy and specialists from Boeing carried out simulated launch and landing of the MQ-25 with the Joint Precision Landing System, a new software-based navigation and approach landing series. The system automates most of the stick and throttle work, pilots testing and certifying on it during spring flight operations on USS Gerald R. Ford have said. The simulations on the Bush will help refine the system's software for MQ-25 operations, with critical data on how motions of a carrier affect landings. Captain Chad Reed, Unmanned Carrier Aviation Program Manager, said, "There is no better way to determine the success of a carrier aircraft design and its integration into the air wing than to put that new aircraft through testing at sea. Our initial look at taxi operations on the flight deck successfully demonstrated the MQ-25's ability to maneuver just like a manned aircraft in the shipboard environment." The Boeing MQ-25 Stingray is an aerial refueling drone that resulted from the carrier-based aerial refueling system, or CBARS, program, which grew out of the earlier unmanned carrier-launched airborne surveillance and strike UCLASS program. In October 2017, the U.S. Navy released the final MQ-25 Stingray RFP. The competitors were Lockheed Martin, Boeing, Northrop Grumman, and General Atomics. General Atomics proposed the Sea Avenger concept, which is an enlarged version of the Avenger drone customized for air refueling. Lockheed Martin put on the table their Sea Ghost design, based on the RQ-170 Sentinel. Northrop Grumman initially proposed X-47B, but later withdrew, stating it wouldn't be able to execute the program under the terms of the service's request for proposals. Boeing came into the competition with a full-fledged prototype derived from its Phantom Ray demonstrator, which ultimately won. The MQ-25 Stingray is powered by a single Rolls-Royce AE 3007N turbofan engine that delivers 10,000 pounds, or 4,500 kilograms, of thrust. The initial contract of $805 million covers the design, development, fabrication, test, and delivery of four Stingray unmanned tanker drones. Ultimately, the contract is worth $13 billion, as around 72 such drones will be inducted in total. The 50-foot-long MQ-25 drone, which can fly 500 nautical miles, or about 925 kilometers, carrying a load of 16,000 pounds of fuel, will be the world's first operational, carrier-based, unmanned aircraft. While the aircraft is less stealthy than flying wing UAVs, it does feature a stealthy fuselage shaping, flush inlet to shield engine blades from radar, and V-tail. MQ-25 is comprised of two major segments: the MQ-25 Air System, Air Vehicle, and the Unmanned Carrier Aviation Mission Control System, UMCS. The system required for carrier integration and command and control of the MQ-25 air vehicle and payload. MQ-25 will be a critical part of the future carrier air wing and is central to the U.S. Navy's strategic unmanned campaign framework, laying the foundation for all future carrier-based unmanned systems and pioneering the cutting-edge manned-unmanned teaming MUMT operational concept. Eventually, all Nimitz and Ford-class carriers will be certified to operate MQ-25. Aircraft carrier flight decks are busy places with no margin for error, so intense testing will be undertaken. Any problem could lead to loss of life and damage to multi-million dollar aircrafts present in the deck. It can be assumed that U.S. Navy will continue with its testing till it's fully satisfied. The U.S. Navy says the MQ-25 will be an important part of future carrier air wings by providing an aerial refueling capability that will extend the range of air wing aircraft. Till now, the U.S. Navy was dependent on land-based tankers, and this created tactical constraints. With MQ-25, the range of carrier-based aircraft will increase drastically, enabling them to be launched from supercarriers that are much further away from the target and beyond the strike envelope of a rival's anti-ship missile systems. The increase in combat radius will provide much more tactical freedom when executing strike missions. It's evident that the MQ-25 will be a crucial asset for the U.S. Navy.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.